From the Douglas County Courthouse at 8700 Hospital Drive, this is 8700.
Welcome to this month's edition of 8700. I'm Rick Martin, Director of Communications and Community Relations for Douglas County. Thank you for joining me for this episode of 8700, where our focus will be to showcase the work of one county service in particular and the person behind it. I'm pleased to introduce you to my special guest, Ms. Colin Cash, Director of Tourism and Film here in Douglas County. Colin, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me, Rick.
It's so funny, you know, just earlier we were talking about your name and your signature on your email. Tell us a little bit about that in particular, Miss.
Well, Colin has traditionally been a male name, so throughout my life, I have struggled to let people that haven't met me yet know that I am a female. In fact, when I went off to college, I found that I was assigned to the boys' dorm. And so as I advanced in my professional career, I started adding that Ms. to my signature so they would know when people call that they are going to speak to a female.
Wow. That's a great story. It's a great story. You know, what is also special about your department is it's the first time the county has had a tourism department and film office, isn't that true?
That's correct. The there used to be a film commission, but as far as an actual county film office, this is the first time that there's been a full-time employee. And it is the first time that the county has had their very own tourism program.
Wow. So I think one of the interesting things about this in particular is many people, I would say the residents, would want to know, how is it paid for? Can you tell me a little bit about how your department is funded?
Exactly. I get a lot of questions about that. Is the tourism department funded out of my regular taxes? What are you doing, you know, with my tax money? But no, tourism is funded strictly through the hotel motel tax. So everybody knows when you travel and you check into the hotel and you pay your sales tax, and then there's always this extra tax that's on there as well. And it's legislated. So if a county or a city has a certain level of hotel motel tax, a portion of that has to go back into a tourism office, a tourism promoting agency. So that money is earmarked, and that's where my entire budget comes from. My salary, everything I do comes from the hotel motel tax. And so that's sort of a self-perpetuating funding mechanism, because the harder I work to bring people into the community, the more people are going to stay in those hotels, they're going to pay more tax, and then that will increase my budget. So it's kind of it's an incentive in itself for me to get out there and put those heads in beds, is what we say.
Gotcha. Tell me a little bit, in addition to putting those heads in beds, what is your department responsible for promoting?
Well, we want to bring people in to experience our the beauty and everything that we have here in Douglas County. But in particular, I'm working on a campaign called Naturally Douglas.
Okay.
We've got the Hydrangea Festival coming up as well. So there are a variety of things that we promote. Anything that could interest someone to come here and spend a little bit of time, because the longer they stay here, the more money they're going to spend.
Gotcha.
And that's why it's important, why tourism is important. We want people that don't live here to come in here, drop some money, and then go back home.
Gotcha. You know, one of those things you talk about, Naturally Douglas campaign.
Yes.
The initiative. A lot of people don't know about the secret gem of Douglas County.
Absolutely.
Sweetwater Creek State Park.
Sweetwater Creek State Park is the number one most visited state park in Georgia. And I know a lot of local people who have never been there. It's in their backyard and they've never been there. But it is. It's a great gem. It's wonderful for us to have that here. And that is a major cornerstone of our Naturally Douglas campaign, because what we're really trying to say is, hey, everybody, we're Metro Atlanta and we're right here. We're this close to the airport. We're this close to downtown. But yet we have almost 8,000 acres of outdoor, of green space and recreation. And Sweetwater Creek State Park, our own Boundary Waters Park and Clinton Park, some of the city parks, Foxhall Resort. We have all of these things. So we just thought this was a great thing to promote because so many people don't realize that we've got the best of both. We're Metro Atlanta, but we've got all this fabulous recreation space and activities and things to do.
Great places to go for on a weekend,
yes,
right?
Exactly. It's naturally Douglas.
Right, right. I understand we have some news to share of a brand new hotel opening its doors in
yes,
Douglas County.
We're really excited about that. I've got a new, and I say I because I am the tourism department, uh-huh. So I say I've got a new hotel opening. We've got a pair of hotels, a Fairfield Courtyard uh-huh. and Marriott,
okay.
that are actually officially open. They haven't had a grand opening yet. They will in a month or so. But they're up on Thornton Road, as are the majority of our Douglas County hotels, the ones that are not inside the city limits. Great new double property that's opening is going to give us close to 200 more hotel rooms in the county that we'll be collecting that tax from.
And that's pretty close in proximity to Sweetwater Creek State Park.
Very, very close. And I started working with some of those Thornton Road hotels a year or so ago to try to come up with some initiatives so that people that were staying in the hotels could go to the park. And so we've kind of been working on a program where if you're a hotel guest at one of our county hotels, you can go down to the park and maybe show your room key or your bill, something mm-hmm. from the hotel, and then they might give you a coupon for something. You know, we're talking. The park has recently got a new manager, okay. so I've got to go back and kind of talk to him. But we had started making those inroads about how we can pull that together of people, because the majority of the people there in those hotels during the week mm-hmm. are business people. It's corporate. But those guys need to get out, those ladies and gentlemen, they need to get out and explore a little bit and do something after they've been in corporate meetings or sales training all day.
Yeah, yeah, so, I know. Good, good, good. I think you touched base on it, but I want to know a little more about the Hydrangea Festival.
Yes, this is the 11th annual Hydrangea Festival. It's the Penny McHenry Hydrangea Festival, and it's coming up the first weekend in June. And it's a really big festival. It brings in a lot of people from all over the Southeast. We've even had people come in from other countries.
Wow.
And it's a flower show. It's a premier flower show that actually will go on here at 8700 Hospital Drive. And it's free. The flower show is free. There will be a marketplace for home and garden. The Old Courthouse Museum will have some events over there. They'll have the miniature gardens. But then the big thing for the Hydrangea Festival, of course, is the garden tours. And that does have a ticket price associated okay. with it. Everything else is free. But those gardens are absolutely fabulous. And some of these gardens have been in Southern Living and have mm-hmm. won awards. So it's really a neat thing for visitors and for the local people. Anyone that hasn't experienced the Hydrangea Festival can at least get out and come to the flower show and visit the market and everything, even if they're not quite ready to purchase a ticket, but it would be well worth it.
Oh, good, good, good. You know, that's one of the highlights, you know, to Douglas County, of
Absolutely.
Course.
Absolutely.
But I also know that there's another highlight pretty much to your department and to Douglas County. And that is up the Douglas County Film Trail.
The Film Trail, yes.
Pretty brand new, isn't it?
Yes, the Film Trail is really the first thing that I worked on creating when I became the full-time tourism director. We already had the Hydrangea Festival and some other things going on, but I looked around and said, we need a product. We need something kind of to hang our hat on. And rather than trying to create something brand new, I saw all the filming that was going on, and then I was put in charge of arranging all the filming that goes on county property. So I said, wow, we can do something with this, because having been in tourism for a number of years, I know that people love to go and visit where things have been filmed. Mm-hmm. After the movie Fried Green Tomatoes came out, people were just flocking to the little town of Juliet, Georgia. And people just love, even when there's nothing there mm-hmm. anymore. I mean, you can go on the Atlanta movie tour and they ride you around and show you empty parking lots where a scene from The Walking Dead was filmed and things like that. So I said, okay, well, let's take all the various places around the county where filming has been done, and we'll mark those places. And we put together a website, a mobile website, so that it's constantly, it's not static. Every time something new is filmed, it's added to the website. And then you it's self-guided. Okay. So you go, you look on the website and you see, okay, like the old jail or somewhere. And you go there and you see the film trail sign. And then you look at the website and it will tell you everything that has been filmed there. And you can even see pictures of what it looked like while it was being filmed.
So in addition to the old jail yes. where filming occurs, what other places people could look forward to?
Well, the old courthouse okay. museum had a lot of filming there. The city has had some filming done around the plaza and the downtown area, their visitor center there. The mall, Arbor Place Mall, we've had several things filmed there. Foxhall Resort, we've already mentioned Foxhall a little bit, we've had some things there. Sweetwater Creek State Park, of course, it's a big, a lot more is filmed there than even I know, because sometimes I don't get informed about it until after, because there's a lot of top secret. I mean, after Samuel L. Jackson is there, after...
And I'll tell you, I live nearby, and
yeah.
rumors had Robert De Niro was there.
Yes, he was. Okay. Actually, Robert De Niro filmed a movie a couple years ago, and apparently the movie wasn't that great. It kind of went straight to video.
Oh, wow.
But if you go up to the park, they've got like all the set after the movie was filmed and it didn't do really good. They just sort of gave the set to the park.
Wow.
So if you go up there uh-huh. into their visitor center, you can see pieces of the set from that movie. Yeah.
Man.
And if you
what other famous stars, mega stars, were in Douglas County?
Oh, wow.
Samuel L. Jackson, Robert De Niro.
The Rock did not make it, but his body double was at Sweetwater Creek State
really?
Park. Yeah. And, of course, we had Channing Tatum and Daniel Craig and
okay.
Adam Driver. All those guys have
really?
Been out in jail. A few weeks ago, I got to be in the same room with Jason Bateman.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And, you know, I actually got to meet somebody just a few days ago.
Oh, yeah. Tell us a little
yeah.
bit about that, because it was on Twitter.
Yes.
And Facebook. Who was that?
Yeah. So the Bobby Brown story has been, BET's been here filming the Bobby Brown story.
Okay.
They've been doing a lot down at the old jail. And I just happened to be eating at Gabe's in downtown, and Bobby and his wife and his bodyguard and a couple of actresses,
okay.
they came in to eat, and I said, hey, are you guys here filming down at the old jail? They're like, yeah. And I said, I'm the person that schedules all that. I schedule everything that's filmed on
wow.
county property. And then they were very gracious. They were very nice. I got my picture made.
Great marketing right then
yeah.
on the point, huh?
And Bobby was asking me, you know, about the different things on the menu. And
okay.
They said how much they enjoyed being in Douglas County, how friendly we were. And they hoped that they got an opportunity to come back.
Wow. That's
yeah,
awesome.
It was.
That's awesome. Tell us about some of the TV shows that are produced right here in Douglas County that people might be familiar with.
Oh, wow. Yeah, there's a lot. Well, Stranger Things has
okay.
been filmed here in various places around, some on private property, private residence,
okay.
But then some in downtown Douglasville, the old City Hall,
mm-hmm.
Some other places on Church Street. Down
okay.
Church Street, there's an old laundromat kind of across from the Ace Hardware. They turned that into an arcade and filmed some things there. They got out in some neighborhoods. So that's a big one, Stranger Things.
Okay.
There's another show called Stand Against Evil. And these are mostly cable shows, but
mm-hmm.
they do have big followings. Stand Against Evil has been filming in Lithia Springs. We've got Tyler Perry's show, The Have and Have Nots.
Okay.
If you watch the opening segment of that show, some of that was in Douglas County. Ozark, I mentioned Jason Bateman, so Ozark is his Netflix show. Let's see, there's a brand new Fox show, mm-hmm. a Marvel show called The Gifted, I believe.
Yes.
They filmed
yes.
some things here.
Okay.
Just, I mean, all kinds of things. I tell people that really in the last 4 or 5 years, if you've seen a TV show or a movie mm-hmm. that had an extensive jail scene, mm-hmm. odds are that it was filmed in the old Douglas County Jail.
Wow.
Because we've had so much film there. And it's not always a jail. That's mm-hmm. the really cool thing about the old jail is that it can stand in for a hospital, a school, it's been a bank vault,
really?
It's been, you know, it's been all kinds of different things.
Okay. That's movie. Movies.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, Ms. Cash, tell me a little bit, how did you get into this industry?
Well, after...
Are you from here?
I am. I'm an Atlanta native.
Okay.
And a West Georgia
okay.
girl. So
okay.
I claim Douglas County
All right.
is right next to home. I grew up when I-20 still stopped at Highway 5 and there was a big red dirt hill, just that's all there was. So I've been around here for a while. But after college, I got a job in Rome, Georgia,
okay.
at their Convention and Visitors Bureau, which is their tourism office. I had graduated from the University of West Georgia, had a degree in English and a minor mass communications.
Mm-hmm.
I was working at the local newspaper, the newspapers of West Georgia. And I saw this ad for this job, and it said group tour coordinator. So I went up there thinking I was applying to be like a tour guide or something, I had no idea. It just so happened that the director there, she also had a background in journalism.
Okay.
So she gave me a chance and brought me in, and I started learning about tourism as an industry and about the hotel motel tax and about all that. So then after I got a little bit of tourism industry under my belt, I went to Carrollton, Georgia when they started their own tourism program.
Okay.
Did that for a number of years, worked through the Olympics, had a great time. And then lo and behold, the city of Douglasville decided they were going to do a tourism program as well. And we laugh about this story when I applied for the job with the city and I was asked by the former city manager, why do you want to leave Carrollton and come to Douglasville? And I said, because Douglasville's going to kick Carrollton's butt if y'all do all this stuff. And so I worked there for a number of years, and then I came to work for the county
okay.
to start their tourism program. So I've
wow.
started several different tourism programs. I've been the inaugural director.
Awesome, awesome. So that, you know, makes you, in my opinion, the perfect person to answer the next question.
Okay.
What advice would you give anyone seeking opportunities to get into this industry?
That's a great question, and one that I love to talk to school kids about, because mm-hmm. I do work closely with Douglas County with their marketing and hospitality and some of the other county schools, and I tell them that the hospitality industry is a great industry that you can come in on the bottom floor not knowing anything and work your way up. So because tourism and hospitality, it's not just like my job, but everyone that works in a hotel, a restaurant, those kind of things. And it's really great if you can't go to college or you need to delay going to college, you can get a job in a restaurant and you can work your way up to management. You can get a job at a hotel, you can work your way up to management. But if you kind of have an idea that you want to get into that, there weren't any really hospitality and tourism degrees when I was going to school. There are some now, but anything that puts you in sort of a marketing, communications, anything like that, you've got to be able to talk to people. And so I would say get a degree in what you love to do if you can. If you can't get a degree, then start in at a hotel, a restaurant, or somewhere, and be prepared to work your way up. But really, it's about being able to talk to people and loving what you do. So that's what hospitality means, you know, mm-hmm. being friendly and welcoming. So mm-hmm. I genuinely love the community that I live in and that I promote, because I couldn't go out and tell everybody how fabulous Douglas County is if I didn't think that it was that fabulous.
So, if you didn't believe in it.
Exactly. So you've got to believe in what you're doing and be friendly and be welcoming about it, and you can have a career in tourism and hospitality.
Wow. Ms. Cash, I can't thank you enough for
joining us here.
Thank you for
having me, Rick. I really appreciate it.
8700. Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Well, that concludes this episode of 8700. Thank you for joining us, and for Ms. Colin Cash, I'm Rick Martin. Until next time.